I'm Stephen Friedman. I'm the president of MTV, and I'm part of a nonprofit makeover, and we just discussed that downstairs. Catch a Fire, this terrific nonprofit, the head of it was actually a mentee, a woman that I was paired up with the city, and I picked her. I wanted to mentor someone who was doing good in the world, and I loved her model. It's a business model where it partners people with a specific skill set who want to volunteer but want to use their unique skill and make a difference. And Catch Fire does that. And over breakfast, we came up with this idea, let's kind of figure out how we do a national search for a nonprofit that could be, hopefully could benefit from what MTV does every day around its content with its big partners. And we did a search. We found CEO, this phenomenal this nonprofit that works in getting people that have been released from incarceration, have served their time, young people who have a really tough time getting jobs. If you can imagine how tough it is for young people in general, then you think about someone who's got a felony. How do they get past that? We thought it was a real great opportunity, and so we worked with them to help them out. People don't want to hear about prisoners. You know, it's an issue that needs to be addressed. It's hard to be addressed. So we tried to figure out a storytelling element. What was the basic, like, distillation that everyone could identify? And the notion of second chances was a really strong one that they talked about. We helped them kind of amplify and shape that. And then from a social media perspective, we fortunately, I'm lucky to have a staff full of young people that are so much smarter than I am, or the senior people who have kind of revolutionized our social footprint. We also brought them in to figure out how do you build momentum with certain constituencies where they'll care about this really important nonprofit that's doing great work. The biggest thing we did was we kind of let go of our expectations and turned the reins over to some young people in their 20s who transformed our social imprint. And it really, what everybody knows now, but I don't think we understood a couple years ago, it's not about marketing. It's about content and a connection and a deep engagement. And it needs to be an authentic voice. And so it is unbelievable now what we can do with, you know, we reach about 160 million people across our various social footprint. That's 60 million more than the 100 million we reach on TV. So a much broader audience that we can talk to every day. And so the people at the front line become brand ambassadors who are really engaging with our audience in a way that TV is not set up to do. So it has really created a much more intimate connection with our audience, and 100% of that is due to the smart young talent on our staff. The great thing about MTV is you've got to reinvent, and every time you think you know an audience, you've got to let go of your expectations and learn it all over. And so I think trusting the audience and kind of hearing where they're going keeps us nimble. And so it's a process we've got to go through every few years. And I just think this young audience now, is they're pioneers on various platforms that weren't imagined, you know, a year ago. So for us, it becomes an experimental way to talk to the audience and create narrative forms that is really unique to this generation that I think will change the nature of storytelling. So I think it is really about listening to them and then listening to the great creators in the group to figure out how you continue the storytelling, which we've done from the beginning of launching MTV.